us this morning, and I thank God for that. But in John chapter number 4, and we'll be reading several verses this morning, John chapter 4 and beginning in verse number 1, when therefore the Lord knew how the Pharisees had heard that Jesus had baptized more disciples than John, though Jesus himself baptized not, but his disciples, he left Judea and departed again into Galilee. He must needs go through Samaria. Then cometh he to a city of Samaria, which is called Sychar, near to the parcel of ground that Jacob gave to his son Joseph. Now Jacob's well was there. Jesus, therefore, being wearied with his journey, sat thus on the well, and it was about the sixth hour. There cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus saith unto her, Give me to drink. For his disciples were gone away unto the city to buy meat. Then saith the woman of Samaria unto him, How is it that thou, being a Jew, askest drink of me, which am a woman of Samaria? For the Jews have no dealings with the Samaritans. Jesus answered and said unto her, If thou knewest the gift of God, and who it is that saith to thee, Give me drink, thou wouldest have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. The woman saith unto him, Sir, thou hast nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. From whence then hast thou that living water? Art thou greater than our father Jacob, which gave us the well, and drank thereof himself, and his children, and his cattle? Jesus answered and said unto her, Whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again, but whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water, springing up into everlasting life. The woman saith unto him, Sir, give me this water, that I thirst not, neither come hither to draw. Jesus saith unto her, Go, call thy husband, and come hither. The woman answered and said, I have no husband. Jesus said unto her, Thou hast well said, I have no husband. For thou hast had five husbands, and he whom thou now hast is not thy husband. In that saidest thou truly. The woman saith unto him, Sir, I perceive that thou art a prophet. Our fathers worshipped in this mountain, and ye say that in Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. Jesus saith unto her, Woman, believe me, the hour cometh when ye shall neither in this mountain nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Father. Ye worship, you know not what. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour cometh and now is, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. The woman saith unto him, I know that Messiah cometh, which is called Christ. When he is come, he will tell us all things. Jesus saith unto her, I that speak unto thee am he. And so I'm going to stop reading there. That's reading verse 1 through 26 of John chapter 3. And if you'd bow your head this morning, we'd ask the Lord's blessing on the word. Heavenly Father God, as we come before you this morning, we thank you for this privilege and opportunity that we have once again to come, Lord, to be in fellowship with the good people, Lord, here in your house at Lewis Lane Central Baptist Church. We thank you, Father, for each and every one that's present in the house of God this morning. And Father God, we ask, Lord, that you would bless those that loved you enough and cared enough, Father, this morning, and were able to come down to the house of God. Those, Father, that are missing from our ranks this morning, that are sick, that are unable, Father, to be in the house of God, or for some other reason, Lord, unable to be in the house of God. I pray, Lord, that you'd be with them, that you'd bless them, you'd help them, you'd strengthen them. Father God, I pray that you'd bless me, your servant, that you'd give me wisdom, you'd give me understanding, Lord, and that you'd anoint me by your Spirit and give me power this morning and ability, Father, to do the preaching that you bid me preach. I pray, God, that you'd bless this word that we've read in our hearing this morning. And Father God, may we be attentive to your words and receive that which you have for us this morning in the house of God. Bless each heart, meet each need. Lord God, whatever you do, Father, we'll thank you. God, we'll give you the glory, the honor, and the praise for it all, because we know that you're worthy in Jesus' sweet and holy name. Now, I read all of those verses this morning, my beloved, just to get into context of what we're going to mainly be looking at this morning in the passage. And really just mainly two verses of this morning that we're going to read or we're going to deal with. But looking in verse number 23, Jesus said, "But the hour cometh, and now is, for the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth, for the Father seeketh such to worship him." And I'd like to preach to you just a little while this morning from this passage of Scripture on the thought of what the Father seeks. What does God seek this morning, my beloved friend, looking at this passage and what Jesus told this woman this morning? You notice here what he said. Again, in verse number 23, he said, "The hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth, for the Father seeketh such to worship him." What does God, amen, the Father seek this morning? Well, I want to say, first of all, my beloved friend, he seeketh such. That word "such," as he's used it in this passage this morning, my beloved, amen, refers to people, to human beings, my beloved. And God, from the beginning, has sought human beings to worship him. Thank God, my beloved friend, that's the reason we were put here in the first place. That's why God made us this morning in the first place. That's why God created us this morning in the first place, amen, that we might worship him, beloved friend. He's the one that made us, and he made us that we might worship him. And you remember, my beloved friend, amen, that God had made man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. And the Bible tells us that he made the woman, amen, also, and brought her unto the man and presented her to him. And so God performed the first wedding, my beloved friend, there that day, and created the family there that day, my beloved friend. And he made them, and he created them to worship him. That's the reason, as I said, that God made us. That's the purpose and the reason for every one of us coming into this world. Amen. That's the reason for our being this morning. Amen. We were placed in this world, amen, that we might bring glory and honor to him, and that we might worship him. That's our purpose, and that's our reason for being this morning. And that's why God made us in the first place. I thank God. I remember those elders, my beloved. Amen. As John is caught up in Revelation chapter 4 into the third heaven, and he sees God upon the throne, and he sees the 24 elders there before the throne. And the Bible tells us that those 24 elders, amen, rise up, and they cast their crowns before the throne of God and declare, "Thou art worthy to receive honor and glory and power, for thy will was all things, for thy honor and thy glory was all things created." Amen. And the Bible tells us again, amen, in another place, amen, that he made all things, amen, for his glory, amen, and for his honor. He made you and I, amen, that we might bring honor to him and glory to him. We were created, my beloved, amen, to worship him. That's why God made us, amen, my beloved friend. That's why we were brought into this world, that we might bring glory and honor to him. Thank God, all things were amen. In Colossians, Paul tells us, amen, all things are and were created for his glory and for his honor. That's our reason for being. Amen. That's our purpose for being in this world, that we might bring glory and honor to him. And so God seeks somebody, my beloved. Amen. He seeks such to worship him. He seeks somebody this morning. I thank God to worship him in spirit and truth. He wants you and I this morning, my beloved, amen, to bring glory and honor to him. That's my desire this morning. Amen. I want to bring glory and honor to God. Amen. I want to bring glory and honor to him this morning. I thank God in my worship in the house of God. I want to bring glory and honor to him. First of all, my beloved friend, that's the reason he called me. Amen. My number one job this morning, my beloved, as a minister in the house of God, is that I might bring glory and honor to him, that I might lift up the name of Jesus to a lost and a dying world, my beloved friend, and that I might be a help to somebody. But my number one purpose, my beloved, and your number one purpose, is to bring glory and honor to him. Thank God. He seeketh such, amen, to worship him. He wants you and I. Amen. I want my life, my beloved, amen, to matter for Jesus. I want my life, amen, to matter for God. Amen. I want to live in such a way, my beloved, I want to walk daily down here on this earth in such a way that it would bring glory and that it would bring honor to him, thank God, through Jesus Christ. That's my purpose, and that's my reason for being, and it is yours too this morning, my beloved friend. And you remember, as Adam and Eve had sinned there in the garden, and my beloved friend, and their eyes were open. Amen. They ate of the forbidden fruit, and their eyes were open. And they knew that they were naked. And the Bible tells us that they made themselves aprons of fig leaves, and they tried to hide their nakedness. But beloved friend, they heard the voice of the Lord God. Amen. Come walking in the cool of the day. Amen. And the Bible said that they ran and they hid themselves. And God began to cry out and say, Adam, amen, where art thou? Amen. Jesus said that he seeketh such, amen, to worship him. Aren't you glad that he comes seeking for you? Amen. Aren't you glad, my beloved friend, amen, that he came looking for you? Well, I want to tell you, the night that I was saved by the grace of God, amen, I was not looking for him. But thank God, I'm glad that he came looking for me. I'm glad that he came where I was when I could not get to him. Thank God, I'm glad he came looking for me. He came seeking me. Thank God, he came where I was, my beloved friend, and he rescued me, and he delivered me from the power of darkness and the power of Satan. I thank God. David said he drew me up also out of an horrible pit, out of the miry clay. I thank God and put my feet upon a rock and established my going and put a new song in my mouth, even praise unto our God. I'm glad that he came looking for me. Yes, what a blessing that is. Amen. He seeketh such, amen, to worship him. That's why that he stood up on that feast day one time, and he cried out and said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I'm meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest, thank God, for your soul. What a blessing that is. I'm glad you come looking for me. Yes, he seeketh such to worship him. Oh, listen, he began to cry out and say, Adam, where art thou? And Adam cried out and said, we heard your voice come walk in the cool of day, and we knew that we were naked, and we ran and we hid ourselves. And you know the story, my beloved friend, how God got the confession out of Adam, and he got the confession out of Eve, and he passed judgment on the serpent and upon their sin. And the Bible said he made them coats of skins, thank God, and covered their nakedness. Amen. He shed the blood of the innocent animal, and he made a way for them, thank God, that their spiritual nakedness could be covered. What a blessing that is. I'm glad he come seeking for me. Yes, Jesus said, I come. Amen. To seek and to save that which was lost. Thank God, what a blessing that is. Oh, he said, what shepherd among you? Amen. When the 99 are saved in the fold. But you have a little lost sheep wandering out there in the cold. He said, what shepherd among you doth not leave the 99 and go look for that one little lost sheep until you find it? And he said, I'm here to tell you, amen, he talking about the sinner. He said, there's more rejoicing in heaven over one sinner that repented than 99 that need no repentance. Amen, that sinner was me. That lost sheep was me. And he come looking for me, thank God, until he found me and he saved me. What a blessing that is. Amen. He seeketh such. Amen. To worship him. Thank God, I'm glad. Amen. I don't see what he sees in me this morning. Oh, I want to tell you, I don't know why that he'd want to save me. I can tell you right now, my beloved friend. Amen. There ain't nothing good in me. But thank God, I'm glad he loved me so much that he was willing to bleed and die for me on the cross of Calvary and shed his life blood that I could have life and could have it more abundantly. What a blessing that is. Yes, I'm glad he came looking for me. Oh, listen. Amen. He told her, said, the hour cometh. And now he is one of the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. Oh, what does the Father seek this morning? Amen. He's seeking my worship. And he's seeking your worship this morning. Oh, he wants us to praise him this morning. Oh, he wants us to give glory. And that's what the word worship means. Oh, the word worship means to honor. And oh, how I want to honor him. How the word worship means to praise. And oh, how I want to praise him this morning. Yes, he seeks such to worship. He wants our worship this morning. He wants us to worship him in spirit and in truth. He's seeking for it this morning. He longs for it. He desires it, my beloved friend. He wants our worship this morning. What a blessing that is. Amen. That's the number one reason for being here this morning. Yes, thank God. Amen. Somebody said, preacher, I come to get fed. That's good. Amen. And God wants to feed you this morning. Amen. Preacher, I come to get a blessing. That's good. Amen. God wants to bless you this morning. Oh, listen, but I want to tell you something, honey. Amen. The number one thing, the number one reason why you're here this morning, it ain't to be seen. Amen. It ain't to be noticed. And honey, the number one reason why that we're gathered here in the house of God this morning is that we might worship his holy name. Thank God. He's worthy this morning. Yes, yes, what a blessing that is. He's seeking such to worship him. God wants somebody to worship him this morning. Oh, listen, my beloved friend. Oh, he said in Psalms 29:2, give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name. Worship him in the beauty of holiness. Oh, he wants our worship this morning. He wants to be glorified by us. Amen. Thank God. He wants somebody to lift up holy hands this morning and worship him. Oh, he wants somebody this morning, amen, to worship him as the choir did when they came up this morning and as Mother did when she came up this morning. Amen. He wants somebody to worship him in song this morning. And as the instruments were played, he wants somebody, thank God, amen, to worship him in music this morning. And he wants us to worship him in praise, thank God.
Oh, he said, oh, give thanks to the Lord, for his good. His mercy endureth forever. Boy, he wants our thanks this morning. He wants our gratitude. Yes, I'm so thankful this morning that I can stand before you and I can say that I have been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I'm saved by the grace of God. I'm a member of the family of God. I'm a child of the living God. What a blessing. I'm a Christian this morning, thank God. I've been saved by the grace of God. Amen. One day after a while, when I leave this walk of life, amen, I'm glad heaven's going to be my home. No, I want to tell you, amen, I used to, when I was a young Christian, I'd hear the old saints of God talk about how they looked forward to the Lord, to going home to be with the Lord. And I couldn't understand that. See, I was young. I didn't realize how many people they had lost out of their life. I didn't realize, my beloved, the trials that they'd been through and the heartaches that they had been through, because I hadn't faced them yet. But I understand it this morning. The older I get, the more I desire to go home to be with Him. What a glorious day that's going to be. And I want to praise Him, because I know to be absent from the body, it's to be present with the Lord for the believer. I know I'm going to go home to be with Him. That's why I want to worship Him. That's why I want to give Him glory. That's why I want to give Him the honor that's due unto His name. Because He's worthy this morning. What a blessing that is. He seeketh such to worship Him. Well, I want to tell you, if you're going to give true worship this morning, make one way you can give it, honey. Amen, that God's going to receive it. You notice here what He said again. Amen, He said, he tells us in verse number 23, the hour is coming and now is when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship Him. God is a spirit, and they that worship Him must worship Him in spirit and in truth. Amen. God the Father this morning, amen, is seeking for you and I to worship in the Spirit of God. Amen. In the power of the Holy Ghost this morning. Amen. God wants us to worship Him in the Spirit. God is a Spirit, and the true worshipers must worship Him in spirit and in truth. Thank God. And that's the only kind He's going to receive this morning. It's going to have to be in spirit. Oh, I want to tell you, I want God the Holy Ghost to have free reign at Lewis Lane Central Baptist Church. I want God the Holy Ghost to have free reign in the life of Chris Christian. I want God the Holy Ghost to have free reign in your lives this morning. I want you to be blessed of the Holy Ghost, and I want to be blessed of the Holy Ghost, and I want this church this morning to be blessed of the Spirit of God. Oh, if it ain't of the Spirit of God this morning, I don't want it, honey. Yes, I mean, that's why God said try the spirits to see whether they be of God or not. And you say, preacher, how do you know whether it is or whether it's not? Amen, that it's of God, it's going to speak of Him. Amen, Jesus said when He is come, He shall not speak of Himself, but He shall take of mine and shall show it unto you. Thank God, it'll bring glory and honor to Him this morning. Yes. I'm going to tell you, thank God, amen, I'm a Central Baptist, and I'm proud to be a Central Baptist. Amen, I was ordained in the Central Baptist about 35 years ago. If I remember correctly, 37 years ago, I preached my first message, not in a Central Baptist church, but up on the hillside behind it. Amen. I began my ministry in a Central Baptist church. And I'm proud how to be a Central Baptist. Well, I want to tell you this morning. Amen. I don't glorify the Central Baptist. It wasn't the Central Baptist that saved me this morning. Thank God it was the Lord Jesus Christ. Now I want to bring glory and honor to Him. Through the person of the Holy Ghost, I feel Him this morning, don't you? Oh, I'm glad I can feel Him, thank God.
Yes.
What a blessing that is. I'm glad I've got something that's real.
Yes.
Somebody said, preacher, you're not saved by emotion. No, you're not. But thank God, I'm glad there's some emotion in salvation.
Yes,
amen. Listen, my beloved. Amen. When thou God told, amen, the angel Gabriel told Mary, amen, said it's a 6 month with her that was called barren. And she went to see her cousin Elizabeth. And as she began to hail the house, amen, the Bible tells us, amen, that when Mary heard the salutation, or when Martha heard, when Elizabeth heard the salutation of Mary, the babe leaped in her womb, and she was filled with the Holy Ghost, and spake out with a loud voice, and glorified God. What a blessing that is. I want Him to move me this morning.
Yes,
thank God. And I don't want to make a move without Him. Amen. Amen. I remember one time, the biggest hurt I ever got from another preacher. I got invited as a young preacher to preach. Amen. I really got fired up. And the members of this church, God moved and He blessed in a great way, and the people of the church enjoyed it. And when I came, I got in a big way, and I took my coat off, and I loosened my tie, and I rolled up my sleeves. And when I got done, I went over, and I picked up my coat, and I started down off the stage. And when I did, the pastor came to meet me with the right hand. I thought of fellowship. And I thought He was going to encourage me like every other pastor had done, whose church I preached in. And He stepped up close to me and took me by the hand. And He said, you know, He said, I used to preach like you. But He said, I learned better. He said, when you get up there and you do that, He said, people are just watching you. He said, you're just working on their emotions. And He said, they don't remember anything you said. And I thought to myself, I mean, God poured it out on me. I don't want to know better. I don't want to know better this morning. And they may think that I'm crazy. And they may say that I'm too loud. And they may say that I'm some kind of fanatic. But I want to worship my God in spirit and in truth this morning. I don't want to know better. Thank God. I want to tell you, honey, there ain't nothing better. Amen. Other than being saved by the grace of God, they ain't nothing better than a good old time. Amen. Blessing by the Holy Ghost this morning. And they ain't nothing better, thank God, of what a blessing that is. I want to worship the Lord. Amen. Spirit. And God expects the true worshipers to do that. And honey, if you ain't worshiping Him in spirit and in truth, you're not a true worshiper this morning. Your worship is not true. I didn't say you wasn't saved. I said you worship in truth. Amen. You see, beloved friend, amen, I think we just need to let go sometimes and let God have His way. I mean, He's got us a blessing this morning. And I've used this analogy many times over the years in revival meetings when I was opening up and I was trying to make people comfortable and trying to let them know that it was okay in the church that I was pastoring to worship God in spirit and in truth. I wasn't going to put any checks on them. Amen. I wasn't going to bind them down. I wasn't going to put any limitations on them and on the Holy Ghost. You know what the Word of God said? He said, I prepare you a table in the presence of your enemies. Now I want to ask you something this morning. If He will prepare you and I a table in the presence of our enemies. How much more here among our family, amen, among the people of God, in the house of God, will He prepare a table for me and a table for you. My God, you remember after that He rose from the dead, Peter said, I go a-fishing. Amen. That one that Brother Steve mentioned this morning, that wasn't the only time that Peter then went back to fishing. Amen. There's another time after the Lord rose. Peter said, I go a-fishing. And the rest of the disciples said, well, we'll just go with you. Amen. And again, they pulled all the net, and they caught nothing. And Jesus appeared to them on the seashore. And He cried out and said, children, have you any meat? And they said, no. Peter recognized Him. He's out there naked. Amen. Didn't have any clothes on. Amen. What kind of look was that for a preacher? Didn't have any clothes on. He grabbed his coat himself and jumped in the water because he was ashamed. Oh, they came to land. Amen. They caught a great amount of fish. Amen. And when they came to shore, they saw Jesus sitting there to the fire. Amen. With a fish broiling on the fire. And He told His disciples, He said, come and dine. Come and dine. He's inviting us this morning. Each and every time that we come down to the house of God, He's inviting us, amen, to come into His house, amen, to pull up to His table, and to come and to dine. He's got spiritual food for us this morning, if we want Him. Thank God, what does the Lord seek this morning? What does the Father seek? Amen. Notice here what He said. Amen. The hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship Him. God is a spirit, and they that worship Him must worship Him in spirit and in truth. Amen. As Jesus, Acts chapter 1, as Jesus was making His way, amen, up to the Mount of Olives, and He was getting ready, amen, to be called away. He told them, He said, now boys, I want you to go to Jerusalem, Acts 1:4. And He said, there, I want you to wait after the promise from the Father, thank God. Amen. He was talking about the Holy Ghost. He said, ye shall receive power from on high. And ye shall be witnesses of me, both in Jerusalem and in Judea and in Samaria and the uttermost part of the earth. He said, you go to Jerusalem and you wait for the promise from the Father. What was that promise? He had already told them in the upper room in John's Gospel. He said, it's expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Holy Ghost, the Comforter shall not come unto you. But if I go away, He said, I'll send you another Comforter. And He it is that shall lead you and guide you into all truths and paths of righteousness, my God. He said, I want you to wait for the promise. You've heard me read this, and you've heard me quote this several times recently in messages. Amen. Acts chapter 2, they were there gathered together in one place, in one mind, and in one accord, and they were waiting for that promise, thank God. And the Holy Spirit appeared as cloven tongues of fire and sat out on each one of them and filled all the house. I want to tell you, if we come into the house of God with expectation this morning, thank God, I believe we won't go away hungry. I believe we'll be filled this morning. What a blessing that is. He seeketh such to worship Him in spirit. Then the last thing I want to give you, and I'm going to come to close this morning. Amen. God is a spirit, and they that worship Him must worship Him in spirit and in truth. Thank God. What a blessing that is. One place Paul told them, he said, I came among you determined not to know anything but Jesus Christ and Him crucified. I'm here to tell you this morning, I don't have anything else for you. Amen. If you come, my beloved, expecting some psychological preaching, I'm sorry. You're going to be disappointed this morning. Amen. If you come, and my beloved, expecting me to be some kind of a motivational speaker, I'm sorry. You're going to be disappointed this morning. If you come expecting me to build up your self-esteem, I'm sorry. You're going to be disappointed. But oh, if you come this morning expecting something from Him, He won't disappoint you this morning. And I don't have anything for you this morning but the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Paul said, I came among you determined not to know anything, saving Jesus Christ and Him crucified. Amen. 1 Corinthians 15. He said, I delivered unto you, first of all, that which I also received. How that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, and that He was buried, and that He rose again the third day according to the Scriptures. I want to tell you, honey, the same thing that saved me is going to save somebody else. Amen. The same thing that will help me is going to help somebody else, thank God. And we all came into this thing the same way. And we're all blessed, and we're all strengthened, and we're all encouraged the same way. And I can't say, beloved friend, that I'll do it perfectly because I'm human and I'm a man. But I want to tell you this morning, beloved friend, if it's not in this precious book, I don't want to say it, amen. Thank God, if I can't back it up with this book, I don't want to say it this morning. I only want to say what thus saith the Word of God. And honey, that's the only thing going to help you anyway. And the only thing going to help me this morning. They that worship Him must worship Him in spirit and in truth. Oh, I want to tell you, I could get up here this morning, I could take my text from Sports Illustrated, but it wouldn't help you. Amen. I could take my text from the Journal of Medicine, but it wouldn't help you. I could take my text from the TV Guide this morning, but it wouldn't help you. The only thing going to help you is what thus saith the Word of the living God. Amen. David said, Thy Word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Again, David said, I will hide Thine Word in my heart that I might not sin against God. Oh, I want to tell you, the Word gets the job done this morning. Amen. Oh, listen, Paul declared the Word of God is quick. That means it's alive and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and discernment of the thoughts and intents of the heart. And all things are naked and open before the eyes of Him with whom we have to do the Word of God to get the job done. Amen. It'll reclaim the backslider. Thank God. It'll bring conviction to the heart of the lost. It'll encourage the saint, thank God. It'll strengthen the weak this morning, my beloved. Yes, thank God. Amen. This morning, in his lesson in the book of Luke, amen, Brother Steve talked about the temptation of Jesus. Amen. And that first thing that Satan came when Jesus had not eaten for 40 days and he was in hunger. The very first attack that Satan made against him, amen, was lust of the flesh. He came to him and he told him, he said, if thou be the Son of God, command these stones that they be made bread. Jesus answered and followed him with the Word of God and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone. Amen.
Luke's gospel says, but by the word of God. Matthew tells us everything that Jesus said, by every word, how that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. That's why it's important this morning that I preach the whole book, that Brother Steve teach the whole book. Amen, that this church stand on the whole book, because we need it all this morning.
All scripture is given by inspiration of God is for doctrine, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, and for reproof, for correction in righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto every good work. What does the Lord require this morning? Amen. What does he see? What does the Father see? He seeks somebody this morning to worship him in spirit and in truth. I'm going to do that this morning, don't you? I think we have. I think we've honored him this morning. Amen. I thank God for the Spirit of God this morning.